Hi guys, welcome back to GKCodelabs. In this session, we are going to discuss about RDDs, caching and persistence. These are the two terms which you might have heard if you are into Spark, and some of you might have confusion because the literal meaning of them is somewhat same. Persisting an RDD and caching an RDD. So is there any difference and when do we need them? That is what we are going to discuss in this session. Suppose you are dealing with an RDD. You are doing some map operation or some reduce by key or anything. That operation will be done in memory, obviously, as per Spark concepts. But in case you are done with using an RDD and you expect something, some operation to be done on that RDD in future, in some near future, then what you might consider is persisting that RDD. Because if none of the operation on that RDD is being done, that might not be anymore in your memory because no computation has been done on that data. But if you are sure that no matter I'm not doing this operation on this data as of now, but very near future or after two or three statements or any alternate job, I'm going to use this data, then you might consider persisting or caching this RDD into memory. Persisting and caching means same. Not functionally, but the meaning is same, that storing that data or retaining that particular data into memory, as far as we explicitly mention not to. Now, what is the difference between persist and cache? So to understand this, it's better you understand what are different storage levels for persisting or caching an RDD. So Spark by default provides us multiple storage levels. Let us discuss these quickly and then we can understand more what is persistence and what is caching. So first storage level is memory only. Memory only in a sense, whatever persisting or caching I'm doing, just stored that data into memory. Now what if I am trying to persist or cache a data more than the memory what actually I have? Suppose I have 100 GB of memory and I'm trying to cache a data 150 GB of worth. In that case, if the storage level is memory only, usually you know, right? If the data is more than the memory, the data will start spilling to disk. But if the storage level is memory only, it won't spill to disk. It won't even cache at all. What will happen is, as it is an RDD that is resilient, until unless memory is there, that is 100 GB. Apart from that, whatever 50 GB data is there, that won't be stored anywhere. But in case that is required, that will be recomputed on the fly. That is another feature of RDD that we have already discussed. Okay, so this is what will happen if the storage level is memory only. Just understand this quickly, then we will come to persistence and caching. Second storage level is memory and disk. Memory and disk is what by default we discussed. If memory isn't available, suppose in that similar example, in that case 100 GB will be stored into memory and 50 GB might be spilled to disk. So memory and disk, it stands for that. And whatever these two examples we saw, memory only and memory disk, in these cases the data will be stored as it is. Whatever data we have, this will be stored as it is, either on memory or maybe spill to disk on these two storage levels. Normally means it will not be serialized. Serialized, as you know, it is stored in a binary format, but in these two default storage levels, it won't be stored in a serialized format. It will be deserialized, or you can say as it is. Another option which will make sense to you now is memory only SER, that is memory only serialized. Same way as memory only, but the data now that will be stored will be serialized. So this is more optimal as the data is serialized and it will take less space. Why they have mentioned Java and Scala here is because Spark runs on JVM, and there is a different serialization library for JVMs, and that is for Java and Scala, which are a JVM languages. And in case you are using Python, a different set of serializer is there that we'll come to later. Then another storage level is memory and disk SER. Similarly, memory plus disk, it will be spilled to disk in case memory is full, but the data also will be serialized. So similar, Java and Scala for the same reason. Another is disk only. That is also one of the option that Spark provides us, that the data will be stored on disk only, no memory into play. Now this is interesting. Memory only 2 and memory and disk 2. What does this mean? This gives you an option to distribute that into two cluster nodes. The concept is same as above, but this will be distributed into two cluster nodes. Another is off heap, which is not much used. This is same as the memory only serialized, but that needs an off heap component to be enabled. That is not much used. Now here they have mentioned in Python stored objects will be serialized with the pickle library. So as we told here, memory only serialized and memory and disk serialized. This needs the data to be serialized. And for serializing a data, some or the other code is needed, which actually reads the data, serializes the data. So while working on JVMs, it uses the JVM serializer. But in case of Python, which is a non-JVM language, they use a third-party pickle serializer, which is the reason that if you are using Python, you cannot use these two particular storage levels, that is memory only SER and memory and disk SER. Again, they have mentioned Java and Scala for this, because in case you are using this storage level, memory only SER, this is going to use JVM serializer, and Python does not run on JVM. It is going to use pickle, the third party library, to serialize the data. So that is the reason you can only use memory only, memory disk, and the other apart from the SER versions of the storage level that Spark provide. Okay, so that was about the storage levels. Now let's come to caching and persistence. That was our initial topic. And now this will make much sense to you, because caching is nothing but storing your RDD or your data inside your distributed RDD with a default storage level, that is memory only. So in case you want to work quick and you just want to persist that data, and it makes much sense when we are computing all the data in memory and we store the data in memory. So that is much handy. So what everyone prefers is just cache that data. But if you understand behind that is caching the data means storing the data in this first storage level, that is memory only. So if you cache the data, that is well and fine. But the data behind under the hood will be on memory only storage level. But apart from that, if you want to tweak something and you want to store it into some other storage level, in that case you have to use persist. So that is the difference between cache and persist. If you have any particular requirement for this, please try this persist and cache. And let me know your experiences, and let me know in case you face any issues. I'll discuss that. And that was all for this video. Please hit that like button if you liked this video. And if you have any confusion still, please let me know in the comment section below. And please subscribe to my channel if you have not already done. And stay tuned to Apache Spark series. Thank you guys. See you later.